Well, welcome back to Liquid Audio in Perth, Western Australia. Liquid Audio, cherishing classic audio. You're with a sick mic at the moment, and I'm working on this lovely TEAC VRDS 10 CD player. And it has a few issues. The drawer won't operate, so I'm going to sort of have to pull the mech out and have a good look at that. And there are some other issues here too. I think you can see, but there's a resistor that's burned up here on this board right next to what looks like a Zener. I don't know if it's a Zener or a regular die, but it's obviously gotten a little bit warm there. Plus there's some corrosive glue action, which I've just chipped away from around the base of this capacitor. So I've got to sort this out anyway. It's power supply related. Actually it's not power supply. Yeah, it is power supply related. It's power supply related, but it may not relate to the drawer, but we'll have to sort of have a bit of a look and see how we go. I'm just going to fix this anyway, because it has to be fixed. And then I'll just continue with sort of debugging the machine. Okay, so here we are with just the chassis now of the VRDS-10. Here's the rest of it. So this is the mechanism. Now these are notoriously sort of complicated to pull apart, and of course this is no different. There's multiple stages of disassembly. Got to take out this analog board, and you've got to remove this power supply board, servo PC board, the servo slash power supply board. You've got to disassemble that a little bit to be able to take out this, which is the drive mechanism or the loader. That's all got to come out. There's various belts and things in here as well that we have to sort out. And I'm just going to go through now and make sure that all those belts are okay. If they're not okay, then obviously we'll replace them. But the belts seem to be okay. I've made a repair here. You can see that resistor. It's a new resistor. There was some damage on the underside of the board where the heat had caused the tracks to lift. So I've gone through and repaired that using a sort of a brace technique, which I utilize there to use the adhesion of the adjacent areas of pad where the pads directly around the component legs had just lifted and just fell off. The adjacent areas are still nice and strong, but you've got to expose copper, and I use a little glass fiber pen for that. These glass fiber pens are fantastic, absolutely fantastic. I mean, that I can't tell you how much I use that. Just don't breathe in those fibers. Anyway, back to this. So let's keep going with this mech and see if we can work out what's going on. There may be a bigger problem here, but at least I want to do this part and see where we get to. So let's continue. Worth making a little note and mention of the fact that here we have the famous Sony KSS-151A linear magnetic rail mechanism, which is just a great laser, very long lasting. And of course, it's a VRDS mechanism, which means that this just is a little clamp. This isn't driven by a spindle motor. The spindle motor in this guy is this unit here, and it's a direct drive. Beautiful big direct drive spindle motor with very high rotational inertia compared to regular spindle motor designs. Really, really nicely designed there by TEAC. Everything here is great. What I've done here in this case is lubricated the rail, lubricated all of these little mechanisms. Check the belt. This belt is okay. Lubricated the two motors. I've just cleaned this belt. It's pretty good, but I may replace this belt. This is the tray drive belt. I'll probably replace that. And then other than that, we'll put it back together and then see if it's working. Let's see if this has repaired that part of the problem. I don't know. It certainly is power supply related, but whether or not this had anything to do with the tray drive, I don't yet know. Probably not. Okay, so back here with the VRDS 10, and just sort of anticipating the comments about, Mike, you're only changing the tray drive belt, why not also change the CD clamper drive belt? I thought about this and I thought, yeah, no, it's a good point. I mean, if I'm going to all this effort to take the damn thing apart, and you can see that I have gone to some considerable effort here, I may as well change all the drive belts. So I have a couple of new drive belts here mixed in with the old drive belts, and I will replace this one. You can see I've pulled it all apart. It's a pain in the ass, but anyway. And then I'll replace this one, which is very easy. Then we'll put the whole thing back together and see how she runs. After that, look at my workbench. It's just outrageous. Look, I've got a motorcycle, TEAC CD player, tools, chemicals, VRDS-10, VRDS-10, multimeters, desoldering tools, Technics SEA100, Technics SEA100 boards, various other measurement tools, Yamaha NS10Ms. I need a break. So everyone, the moment of truth, the TEAC VRDS-10. Let's see. Now remember, initially this would not load, unload. This disc was stuck inside and absolutely nothing would happen. In fact, when you hit play or open or close, nothing would happen at all. So let's have a look now. Keep note that I haven't got the front bezel or fascia on the tray, but let's have a look. Now, that's very encouraging. And then we've got a little clamping thing that occurs, and then a little disc read. You little ripper. And then I'm hoping that if I hit play, yep, it starts spinning and we are playing. So that is a terrific result. Full service repair, including repairing that resistor that dies in the power supply on the analog board. Full repair and service on this stunning TEAC VRDS-10. It really is a lovely player, I've got to say. It's just so nicely put together. Yes, it's a pain in the ass to service. I mean, it is, it really is. But having said that, it's also very rewarding to service because, you know, what a terrific result. So I'm going to hit stop. I'm going to turn it off and I'll put the lid back on and then that's a wrap. Okay, here we are back with this gorgeous TEAC VRDS-10 and it's working beautifully, as you can see. I don't want to play you the Porcupine Tree album that's currently playing, but it's the one that was stuck in there for my customer for quite a period of time. It wouldn't come out. Anyway, you can maybe see, sorry about the camera work there, I do apologize, but you can see spinning and very quickly. Don't know if you can hear it, but yeah, it's good. Running nicely. Let's see. Pause. Good. Play. Good. Next track. Good. So yeah, let's stop it and let's open it one more time. Lovely. What a lovely mechanism. I'm going to leave the disc in there for him. There's no reason why that needs to come out. I'll leave it in there and he can collect the player with the disc inside. But anyway, look, that's a TEAC VRDS-10 overhaul and repair. Or service and repair, actually. And if you'd like me to look at yours, just get in touch with me, Mike at Liquid Audio in Perth, Western Australia. Had a very long day. I'm very tired. But as always, appreciate everyone watching, liking, subscribing, and commenting if they feel the need. Until the next one, see ya.